understand. Once he was a family man, so surely I would never ever go through it firsthand.
And Southend. I mean, that works for me. I mean, I'm an Essex boy.
It certainly works for me because after you've had 2 or 3 days in Cairns, you can't wait to get away from it.
Really?
Well, yeah. If you're there in it with a film,
yeah,
it's great because you're looked after well. But, you know, 9 times out of 10, the boys that you know, they're punting films. It's work.
Yes.
They're grafting, you know. Oh, you've been out there, you know. But really, you know, when we have film festivals and that, and it's always in London or it's in one of the big cities. And to be quite honest with you, you know, people go to the West End theatres probably once a month, if they're lucky, you know. But really, this is where you want your films seen. Yeah. This is where your films are seen. In places like Southend, like Coventry, like the Liverpools and that, you know.
Yeah.
It's the suburbs in a way. And, you know, we've got a packed audience tonight. Maybe because it's the first night, I don't know. But at the same time, these are the people that go out and pay for their tickets
exactly
and go see the movies, you know.
Good to see them turn out for it as well. And of course, what they're going to see is it's a real friends and family affair, this film, isn't it? Tell us a little bit about it.
Yeah, we took 14 days to make this as a movie, and I'll get to that in a minute. But I've known Karl, who directed his first film as a director, since we were 17 years of age, you know. And the weird thing was, there was another actor who was going to play the part, to start with, and I'd already read the script, but it's like saying to your mate, you know, well, I'll play it.
Yeah.
He might not want you to play it because he might have
someone
else in mind.
So he hadn't asked you at that point,
no,
then? That's,
and then when it fell out of bed, because the other guy had to go and do another job, and I just said, well, do you want me to do it? And he went, well, yeah.
I didn't like to ask.
Well, you know, you don't, as friends, you don't like to impose it on one another. And in fact, it was probably 2 of the happiest weeks I've ever had making a film.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
And of course, but you have surrounded yourself by people you know, haven't you, really, within it as well?
I'm all for nepotism, to be quite honest with you. Why give someone else a job when you give it to one of your kids if you think they're good enough to do it? And yeah, that's fine by me. And we just had an absolute ball. And I've got to tell you, it was a wonderful script. You know, we've kept it very simple.
Yeah.
The Ethem, our camera DOP, has kept it very simple, which allows the story to tell itself.
Right.
It's about the story, you know?
Yeah.
But there's no tricky shots.
No.
It's about that, you know? Very little movement on the camera. And that's very difficult because you need a little... You know, for people to keep an interest in the film, you need a pace.
Yeah.
And we kept away from that. And we juggled with it a little bit, you know, at the end. But all in all, I've got to tell you, it was one of the most pleasing, you know, times for me at work, you know.
And it's great to hear.
I tell you what I love about it as well. It will actually show people, you know, young filmmakers who find it very difficult to get films off the ground, that if you have got a good script and you believe in that script, that you can actually go and make a film, not for nothing.
No.
But, you know, but not for millions and millions of pounds. And it just shows you the scripts are very, very important.
Is that good for you as well now? Because, I mean, you literally had to go off and you went off and did a bit of Hollywood, like, during the course of the film,
didn't
you?
That's what I do. That's my living. I did.
You were De Niro for 3 nights or something.
I had to go and pick up, do some pick-up shots on a film. But, you know, that's...
That's life, I guess.
That kind of paid for me to be able to do this.
Fantastic,
you know, and that's great.
How about TV world nowadays? Is that still something that's part of your calendar, part of your repertoire?
Yeah, because I think so.
You're doing a lot of film work.
You know, there's this thing that goes about, you know, I do movies now, I don't do TV. Nah. To me, it's about the script, you know.
Yeah.
If what I think is a good script, someone else might not think it's a great script. But, you know, I've got to tell you, you see probably better TV scripts. Not so much in the last year, but before that, then you do movies, you know, out of 10 scripts you
get
through.
That's interesting, isn't it?
Yeah, because it's a...
Is that the talented people are moving into TV?
Well, no, I don't think so. I think it's controlled more script.
Right.
I think with TVs, people who put scripts in, they go out and write what they believe in.
Yeah.
The trouble with what happens to a lot of script writers is they go under a studio system or even sometimes at the BBC where they're given a subject to go and write. Which, you know, it might not be, it's not from their art, you know?
Yeah, it's a bit like work a day, isn't
great,
it? Yeah.
Great scripts are usually the ones that someone's just written and gone, have a look at that.
It's good to hear because, of course, we're in a world now where, like, the tough guys on the telly are, like, you know, sweary chefs or running talent shows. I mean, is that your world? I mean, does that annoy you?
I used to love Keith Floyd and the other guy, Rick Stein,
but
you know.
It's Ramsey and Cowell.
Yeah, they're very good. But the trouble is, there's so many of them.
Yeah.
But, I mean, you know, Ramsey's very good. They're all really good at what they do. It's just too much of it, you know? And why you got too much of that? From my point of view, there's no drama.
Right.
They call that drama in itself. But, I want to sit down and watch a great play on the telly or a great film on the telly, you know? Every now and then, please, you know?
Yeah.
I don't want to see someone sitting in some room somewhere, I'm a celebrity, get me out of here, because I don't care about
them.
You know, and that's an horrible thing to say. And then what happens to these people when they finish?
Yeah.
Where is the responsibility of their 15 minutes of fame when they're just dumped and they become, you know, very dangerous?
Do we want to know? I mean,
is someone going to top themselves one day over
there goes your front page headlines there, unfortunately, doesn't it?
Yeah.
But of course, the great news is something like this, you know, the actors in this, the people involved in this kind of film, we may see them in any situation. Making good stuff is making good stuff, regardless of where it shows up in it.
Yeah.
Is that the point with all this sort of thing, Ray?
Yeah, sometimes you have to go and do something you don't want to do because you have to pay the rent.
Yeah.
To be perfectly honest with you, it's like you, whatever you do. I've been very lucky that, you know, I haven't done many of those.
No.
You know, I've done stuff that, you know, maybe some other people might not like, but I like some, like, 44-inch Sheds, Sexy Beast.
Yes.
And all that, you know, that is an example of writers writing something that they believed in, sitting in a room and going, do you know what, how about that?
Yeah.
Rather than being told by a studio what they've got to write.
Yeah.
You know?
And this is right up there with that kind of stuff, yeah?
This is film we made here. Someone sat down, Uncle Karl there, sat down one day and wrote about something he knows about. You know, we're dads.
Yeah.
And about kids.
Yeah.
And something that affects most people,
yeah,
the lucky people in life. We create our own Frankensteins. And we've done that to our mums and dads as well.
Yeah.
You know, and that's kind of what this film's about.
Well, go away and celebrate. I'm delighted that you're here for us. Nice one.
Thank you very much.
Nice. Oh, was that West Ham cufflinks?
No.
Oh!
No, someone spilled some mayo on me thing. And Glen Murphy done me with a coffee earlier on.
Glen Murphy.
I should get him.
What's
red
he
wine,
like?
Red wine all over him.